H.R. 9 seeks to mandate implementations of those same technically implausible and unrealistic emissions goals in order to appease extremists. The bill also seeks to prevent federal funds from being used to withdraw from the flawed Paris Agreement. Americans for Tax Reform estimates the Paris Agreement will cost the U.S. an estimated 6.5 million jobs by 2040 and reduce our gross domestic product by over $2.5 trillion. NARA Consulting estimates those numbers are even higher and that the Paris Agreement will cost the U.S. an estimated 31.6 million jobs by 2040 and reduce our GDP by over $3 trillion. In June of 2017, President Trump announced he will withdraw the United States from the Paris Agreement, stating, and I quote, "The Paris Climate Accord is simply the latest example of Washington entering into an agreement that disadvantages the United States to the exclusive benefit of other countries, leaving the American workers and taxpayers to absorb the cost in terms of lost jobs, lower wages, shuttering factories, and vastly diminishing economic production," end of quote. There are other significant flaws of the Paris Agreement. MIT found the Paris Agreement will only result in global temperature reduction of 0.2 degrees Celsius by 2100. Under the Paris Climate Agreement, China and India will actually increase emissions to at least 2030. The Climate Action Tracker, a group of European research organizations, found that participating parties will not meet their commitments and those are the goals of the Paris Agreement. The European Climate Action Network reported that no single country in Europe is performing sufficiently to meet Paris Agreement goals, and those have been making the most progress on their promises did not make large commitments in the first place. A recent United Nations emissions gap report found all participating countries will have to at least triple their efforts in order to meet the Paris Agreement's basic goals. Given how unrealistic and illogical the Paris Agreement is, the U.S. should not inflict monumental harm on our economy chasing a white unicorn. Fortunately, there is an alternative. Members of the Western Caucus support personal responsibility, less government intervention in our daily lives, and freedom. They defend property rights and believe that private ownership of property is a fundamental right in America. Our vision encourages innovation and less burdensome mandates. Members of the caucus support local control and believe that stewardship of our environment and natural resources is best accomplished by empowering local stakeholders, not victimizing them. The people who depend on the land to provide security for their families and communities understand these resources best. States and municipalities are best suited to deal with local issues than the distant, out-of-touch Washington bureaucrats. The caucus seeks to promote access to our nation's energy and resource potential while pursuing a truly all-the-above energy approach that aims to ensure the U.S. is the global energy leader. Our vision utilizes the current energy renaissance and the American energy dominant policies currently being implemented by the Trump administration. America's energy renaissance is the backbone of our economy. Is a story of freedom, prosperity, and opportunity. After decades of reliance on other countries to meet our energy needs, the U.S. Energy Information Administration projects that America will export more energy than it imports starting in 2020. We are no longer dependent on volatile foreign sources produced in Russia and Saudi Arabia. Recent innovations and technology improvements associated with hydraulic fracturing and horizontal drilling have allowed shale resources previously deemed uneconomical to be developed, and are the main reason the U.S. was the world leader in carbon emissions reductions in 2015, 2016, and 2017. That's right, fracking, demonized by environmental extremists without justification, has proven to be the best energy solution for our environment. Abundant oil and natural gas has reduced electricity bills, kept gas prices low, and provided the largest share of U.S. electric power generation in recent years. The United States is the world's top energy producer, and the American dream is thriving. Passing H.R. 9 and staying in the Paris Agreement threatens that dream. This is not a partisan issue. This is about doing what is right for America and about protecting freedom and opportunity for our children and grandchildren. I urge all members on both sides of the aisle to reject H.R. 9.